Try not to laugh to this Cracker Milk podcast.
What? Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of the Cracker Milk podcast. This week, I'm joined by Elias DeWedger, Chris Slater, and Tamara Clendon. And I am Connor McDuff, and today we are here to chat. Another chitty chat one. We've got our producer, Goo, behind the cameras, as always.
Roll the tape.
What's he doing?
Deal or no deal.
Deal or no deal.
Oh, it's deal. Behind the cameras here, we've got a briefcase. And I think potentially you could win some money.
Is it anchored to the floor?
No, he's just using my speaker stand.
So could you not fucking bring it around in front of the camera and
Goob's
show?
Goob's picked a number, yeah.
And you all got to, by the end, pick your number and then...
What does the number go up
What's
to?
What's between?
100.
Is the number 100?
Yeah, 73 is my answer. Imagine if I just got it then, just
37.
Like that.
That's how it works, baby.
Fucking pick 37, that's reverse me.
I'm going to pick 100, because Goob said... It's 100.
I said between, but yeah.
No, you didn't.
12.
Well, that's good. That's good. Real low.
We'll find out.
And whoever's closest has to kiss the nearest boy. Okay, I don't want to win. I hope it's a low number.
Me too.
Oh, fuck.
Come here, Chrissy boy.
Now, guys, we've had another fun weekend. It's been a good week. Chris, you're back. You've been in New Zealand for 2 weeks.
Loves it.
The land of the hobbits.
Doing some work in an airport, hey?
Doing some work in an
How's
airport.
How's that going?
Great fun. Airports are such a great place to work.
Now, just so you know, I love New Zealand as a place and the fans there, but Chris, how do you feel about Auckland?
Auckland's a shithole.
What?
Waiheke Island, beautiful.
But Lord of Rings shot at there. How can it be a shithole
so
if Lord of
so
Rings
you know,
there?
Just so you know, Auckland is on the North Island. They shot the Shire. All the really pretty shit got shot in the South Island. You know where they shot the North Island? Fucking Mordor. Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, did you see any orcs?
Hobbiton's in the North Island.
Did you see any orcs?
They are so fucking nice.
Did you see any goblins?
It's like disconcertingly nice. They are like the hotel, everything like the service level just leaves us
They're
for
like
shit.
They're like the Canada to
America.
Australia.
I kid you not, the first time we walked into, there's like a restaurant upstairs and I walked in there because a couple other people from the company have been staying at this hotel, so they know the restaurant. I've walked in and this girl goes, she said, oh, you're from the da-da-da company, are you? And I went, yeah. And she goes, oh, and she came out from the counter and gave me a hug and said, good to have you, like a bit, like, and like,
I think
just
she's
like
just
a hug
feeling
hug.
For your fucking organs, dude.
Chris,
she was gonna
she's
harvest.
Just
she did it to
horny.
Everyone.
Yeah.
Dude,
no, that's what we do
like
when we're
they
horny.
They are so nice. They
watch
are
this,
the nicest
this.
People.
Watch this, ready? Watch. I'll show you what I do when I want a copper feel. Oh, are you booking, checking in?
No.
Oh, my God. Please.
Yeah. Sorry,
nah,
I forgot where I was.
No, fuck it. No, fuck it.
You don't even do
well,
the bit.
I didn't want to get felt up.
You're booking it.
I'm gonna.
You weren't gonna get felt up.
I'm gonna take a polyjuice potion and become you for a day and show you what it's like to fucking try and improv with you. I just set up a great bit for the show we do where we get paid, and you go no.
You said you were going to fill me up.
Oh, okay. Well, now that you've upset me, we can move on to the next topic of discussion, which is, did you dress yourself this morning?
I did.
Now, you've moved out of home.
Yeah.
Does that mean your parents aren't picking out your clothes for you?
Yeah.
Okay.
They picked out your clothes for you?
No.
Okay.
I just want to know what's going on here.
Well, you know, I'm a big advocate of the boom boom. So I decided today I would respect that kind of theme and I would dress myself as Boom Boom.
So you've just, what
palette.
You mean is you're wearing brown khakis,
yep.
You're wearing a brown beanie, a brown button up and brown shoes.
Oh no, the black
belt.
Jacket means there's blood in his stool.
I was thinking a charred poo.
I think it's tar.
You can char the outside.
No, black is dried blood. That, they tell you to look out for that in your they tell you to look out for that in your boom booms. So just keep that
Maybe
in my...
Is that why black pudding is black? Because that's my...
This used to be a pure white suit.
Why
did you wear a white power suit?
Yeah,
Elias?
And why does your beanie come as a part of your suit?
Oh, cold.
Okay. So now you're full poo. Stand up. Show everyone the full poo.
Cold.
Just to clarify, he's walked into a job where we film videos for a living, and
I put on the clothes as well.
And he's dressed as a big poo. That is a lot of brown, bud. That is a poo.
They call him Brown Town Elias.
Yeah, they do. So what are you going to do after this? Dig up some soil and squeeze your way in, bury your way in, tie your hands up next to your body so you're a little earthworm? A little brown little earthworm?
Oh, wiggly
earthworms
wiggly.
Are pink.
Earthworm Jim was pink.
It's brown.
Wasn't he?
They're brown.
Is Earthworm Jim still a thing? Is that still a game? Or is that like...
That's like Goob's favourite thing ever.
Oh, really?
Jim. Yeah, he loves Earthworm Jim.
What does it mean?
Oh my god, it's
and
only
then the artist, got,
phone,
the yeah. artist got in trouble because he's a massive transphobe, and so the whole series no. got yeah.
It's very concerning.
That's why Goob didn't like Earthworm Jim before.
Yeah.
Once he found out that, like, yeah, makes you love the art. We're all about separating the art from the artist here, except Goob, who likes to make sure the artist and the art are embedded in each other.
That's right.
It's really frustrating because, like, you know what's annoying? Michael Jackson is so incredible.
Talent.
That musically, like, you listen to Michael Jackson, you're like, this motherfucker just doesn't miss. He's king of pop. Everything he made was so good and so sharp. And as long as I'm listening to that music and I forget who made it, I'm having a great time. And the moment I'm reminded of that man's life, I am like,
I saw the funniest thing. I can't even, it was a TV show. I can't think what it was, but I wet myself laughing. It was only 2 days ago.
I bet you, knowing you, what it is, it's probably a little person with like a physical disability.
No.
And you sent that clip to all of your friends.
So it was this older guy this guy's talking to his son, and he's trying to get him to come with him, right, to get away. Look, he's got to get away from this bad guy, right? He's saying this, and he goes, come
on,
come
make your son come?
And then the other character walks in, the guy's trying to go away from him, and he says, kid said no, mate, no means no, this is not the Neverland Ranch. It was the boys.
Elias didn't know that Michael Jackson lived on Neverland Ranch.
I didn't know it was called Neverland Ranch.
He built a theme park and he'd want to specifically hang out with little kids.
The ultimate honey trap.
Macaulay Culkin said nothing happened.
Yeah, but you know, you're not going to fuck Macaulay Culkin. That's risky.
I mean,
have you seen what he does when he's alone?
slaps his face.
Fucking murders people, dude.
That's right, yeah.
Glory
That's
hole.
Right, the shit he did to those two poor guys.
Dude, he threw a brick at one of them. At one point, he's like, can you chuck me the camera? And he goes, sure. And he just drops a brick on the guy's face. Yeah. And somehow it's comical. That man would have his face bent in. And it'd be on Live Link if that was real.
But they broke in.
What was his name? Daniel?
Day-Lewis.
I want to swap. This guy next to me smells like Boom Boom.
That's right. He looks like Boom Boom.
That's because
looks like Boom Boom, smells like Boom Boom.
Are you
going to
dress
be?
Like a tampon tomorrow?
Pee-pee.
Why? What's so funny about a tampon,
he's
Chris?
He's
going
to wear all white with a pointy hood to dress like a tampon.
Yeah.
Because he has that at home.
Red shoes.
And used to be a black suit.
For string, get some white yarn and tuck it in your butthole so the string sits out. So you look
that's
like...
That's not bad.
Yeah. Not bad. So you could actually use a real tampon if you want it in your butthole to be the...
I like where this was going.
That's alarming that you do.
Why?
Now, you were gone to New South Wales this weekend.
Yeah. I took a train down on Friday morning.
You ran a train
down
on someone with downs.
Yeah.
Cut all that, please.
Leave it in. People need to know.
No, cut the Down syndrome rant.
He's the most coherent.
Legitimately, you have to cut that. I'll be mad if that's in. Don't shrug over there.
He doesn't make you say shit.
I know, but he has to cut it.
Some Louis C.K. like jacking off. In the middle of the podcast, that'd be you can't.
You know
do that.
Something? Why does everyone act like that was sort of chill that Louis C.K. did that? Everyone's like, oh, but he didn't do it to someone else. Have
what do you mean?
Like,
he did? Didn't he do it in front of?
He made girls walk in the room, lock the door, and be like, "Y'all mind if I come on
like
my tummy?"
PAs.
And he sat there in front of him as he's having a chat. Like, that's fucking gross. Mm. Everyone's like, "No, Louis C.K. it's fine." That's yucky, dude. I don't want to be around a dude known for that.
What do you mean? I don't understand.
Lock the door.
Can you ever?
It is.
But is there a. So what's. Like, okay, you commit a crime, you go to jail, you come out of jail, and like it's meant to be. Okay, you've served your time, you're done well. What about someone like a Louis C.K., someone like that, where like.
They
never
still
went to
have
jail
preferences.
But I mean, he did what he did. He's confessed what he did. He's gone and done, disappeared off the scene for, you know, 4 or 5 years, and now he's back trying to do comedy again. Is that okay? Has he served his time? Because he never served any time. He was technically was well.
He didn't break the law. He had no time.
Well,
to
he
serve.
Did. He was not.
It wasn't
he
consensual.
He did break a law. They just never. He was never held accountable for it because they never put charges up on it.
I think it's really yucky, and those girls should have.
So he never gets to do comedy again.
No, I don't fucking care about any of this. I tell you what. You as an individual,
Bill
that's
Cosby.
Your... That's
he
your,
was out there the next day.
Bill Cosby was raping. He was
and he was like, he served his time, and then he went to comedy club.
No.
Like,
yeah, he did. He went, I didn't do it! And then he went to Paul at the forum, and then he went to prison.
In the
he's like, I didn't do it! And then he's like, that's it. You know what I'm going to do with all these date rape charges?
Pretend
tell some
it
jokes.
Never happened.
And then he went to prison. But I feel like...
He got out of prison.
You can, if you're a dirtbag in real life, and you're a piece of shit... You're a piece of shit. You should pay the consequences for being a piece of shit. But that should be in your life. The art you create is art. It's separate from the creator. And that's how come you can grab different amounts of meaning and love from Lord of the Rings to me. You make it your favorite film. I love the film. Or how I can hate something and you love it. Like, I can't name the film because a person we know made it. But there's things that, like, art is up for interpretation, and your collection of human experiences determine how you feel about that art, not the fucking artist. Mm. The artist doesn't determine that.
But what if it comes out that Gandalf was fucking the hobbits?
Okay, if it comes
he
out
he fell
that,
off a stage.
Well, if it well, he did. A better one is, like, if Tolkien, if it came out with 100% evidence that Tolkien wrote the hobbits to be a really horrible representation of, like, Chinese people. I don't fucking know. And so you find out that it's built that's on these, like, racial... But if you're built on, like, racial hate, all these things, and suddenly the art itself, you're like, oh, fuck, this art is, like, built on things that inspired by things that are kind of alarming. It's then up to you as an individual whether or not you want to consume it. But
there's a because Star Trek, that's interesting, because Star Trek is quite openly, and Roddenberry always said everything, but based on the Klingons were like the Japanese feudal society, all that sort of stuff. Romans were the Romulans and all sort of shit. But the Ferengi are very clearly a very, like, fucked up impersonation of a Jewish stereotype. Right.
Yeah.
I've never seen it.
See, the Ferengi. You knew exactly what I was talking about.
Are we talking about the Ferengi?
Yeah. So, I mean, do we fucking cancel Star Trek and say fucking Roddenberry
was... You're aware enough now, like, as media and culture expand and we learn that, like, maybe we shouldn't base races of aliens or characters on, like, marginalized groups. You go, okay, we won't do that anymore. But, like, I don't know, common sense is kind of the answer. Like, look at things through a historical lens, but also look at things like, is this art hurting people? The answer is probably fucking no. We get in trouble all the time, by the way, by people for harming others through our work. So the mermaid video, we got in trouble for the mermaid video because...
excuse me, though. The mermaid video, and I understand they're like, oh, the domestic violence and everything and like that sort of thing, whatever, blah, 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 blah. But then also in the girlfriend interpretive video, the amount of people that called me a toxic horrible shit. It's like, so what spectrum?
This is actually...
I should read these comments,
just open.
You told me not to read the comments.
This is what it is, right? So the mermaid video... Domestic violence is a big thing in Australia, like a very advertised thing. Domestic violence against women is a big deal.
It's a thing.
But because the video, by the way, Lice is convinced that there's a mermaid in the water. It's a woman floating face down in the water. And so the whole argument, that's a dead woman. We were getting, like, it's very popular, but there's people out there who are telling us, there's comments are like, this ain't it, chief. Why would you post this about a dead woman in Australia during a domestic violence epidemic? Let me fucking tell you something. I don't work at the government. I don't beat women. I make jokes. It's not up to me what else is happening in the world. And I don't know why, but we get it all the time.
But
and
I don't understand how they stand up on their, like, soapbox about that.
But then,
like, in the comments, like, the other one, it's just like, oh, all women are like this. They're all dumb, stupid bitches. Oh, they don't communicate. And it's like, so what are the angries? All angry about every angry.
People are way more likely to comment something hateful than nice. And they're also more likely to, we're looking at the fringes of our audience. So you're looking at one end that's like, I like Crack and Milk, they're really funny, but sometimes they take it too far. So those people are looking at our stuff through a filing cabinet of problems. Does this video embellish or represent or perpetuate stereotypes or things? And the other end is, I like Crack and Milk because they'll take risks and they don't care what they say. Mm. But those people aren't in it because they like us. They're in it because they're wanting that shock value. So we want this healthy middle of people who like our content because they like good comedy or like
And we want
comedy.
Them to battle. Yeah. And we want them to battle in the comments.
Tamara,
give my sword.
No, we're not advocating.
Isn't that a thing?
No. You told me not to read the comments.
Give my sword.
So I very rarely do. But occasionally, if I do read the comments, I'll see something like, hey, I like the old guy. And that's the only time I'll ever respond is I'll go on and I'll put a dislike button and put a little old with
a good I'm glad you've got your priorities in order. Tamara sits there and roos.
Why the fuck?
No, I don't. I'm not allowed to.
Oh.
So what was the video that they gave you grief about being toxic?
Oh, no, they gave me grief on everything. I didn't mind. It's fine.
We get grief. This is the nature of the internet.
I want to write sassy things to sassy comments because I think that's fun. But Connor says, don't do it.
No, don't do it.
So then I'm not allowed to.
Because then they keep doing it. But also, like, they can do it.
Yeah, but
people,
I like to do that in real life.
Not real bears. But that's what I mean. In real life, you can poke a bear.
The amount of times I've, like, commented on people's shoes when I don't necessarily like their shoes.
Well, look, this is reality, right? It doesn't matter.
They look great.
It doesn't matter what we make. What's going to happen when we make stuff is we're going to find these people. And we make comedy and, or just so you know, audience, when you see an edgy joke or something, the reason that comes through is not because we want to antagonize to create, get views. Mm. We make jokes built on how fucking funny they are. If we find something funny, it's going to get made. That's pretty much the basis of all of it. And if we find that that joke is funny because it's being derogatory or harmful, we'll rework the joke. Sometimes we toe the line. I think sometimes we might have gotten it wrong. I think there's a couple of jokes we've made that probably
Helen Keller.
No, I said ones we got wrong. Oh. But no, there's a couple that are, yeah, inevitably, like, we misinterpreted. And you know what? We can argue that's in bad taste for a couple of them. But we're just fucking making jokes, baby.
Yeah, I will say, in your defense, it's not done willy-nilly. The conversations are always had.
But we always get, even fucking brands. Like, brands won't work with us. Like, often we are told, hey, we love your stuff, but you're not marketable. And it's just because we make jokes and stuff that take risk. But you know what? Yeah.
That's what we are.
What sort of comedy doesn't...
Well, that's what I mean. You're very rarely seeing a comedian as the face of a product.
Yeah. And what sort of good comedy doesn't take risks? Like, I don't want to make little relatable TikToks about teaching. Emily. No, I don't want to... I don't want to make...
Just so you know, I pitch fucking ideas all the time that he shoots down because they're apparently not PC enough.
Carissa, don't get me started.
On a lighter note, we'll move away from that.
Is this a comedy podcast?
Yeah. But yeah, so I went on a train down to New South Wales.
To Newcastle. Yeah.
He ran a train.
Down in Newcastle in Maitland. It was a 13-hour trip there and back, 3 hours on a bus, 10 hours on a train.
Just to interject with a really important announcement, Group sent me and Elias a photo, and it's an x-ray of a pelvis. And it says, I got that dog in me. And in the x-ray is a corn dog up a man's ass.
Jesus.
I just wanted to let everyone know that the producer of the podcast is doing that while
on the sidelines.
I got that dog in me.
That's right.
Thank you for not yelling at me for sending me shit like that to you. Well.
Oh, yeah. Did we?
Oh, did you get? I sent you a link yesterday. Did you get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
What was the link?
Don't worry.
Red Rockets.
They're called Red Devils, the dick pills you're thinking of.
They're
lipsticks. They are incredible. They're incredible. They thin your blood and they'll kill you. Boner pills.
Oh, I thought they were blue.
That's, what's the other one called? Viagra.
Is Viagra blue?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're the blue minis.
Blue minis is a mushroom, bud.
Is it? Oh, yeah. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't
blue minis is a psychedelic mushroom.
Yeah, it's been taking
what's the name of that mushroom?
That's right. My dick looked like a fucking umbrella.
Whoa.
Gone.
What is it? What would you say over there? Woman?
I gave up.
How you been?
Great.
What's been going on?
Elias wants to finish his story.
That's fine. Don't worry about
the
story.
I want
to
know.
Catch a train to the bus or the bus to the train?
Bus to the train.
Bus from Brisbane to casino.
I know
a train from casino to Newcastle.
Wow.
Did you win any
Do you know where that is? Where you have to where you can't catch a train all the way? Because they make different gauges of fucking railways between New South Wales and Queensland. Like fucking back when they did railways, they had different size fucking gauges.
Yeah,
gauges as in tracks?
Yeah, the width of the track. So the trains that were coming into, they couldn't fucking go across the board.
They usually have it open for trains, but they, it was fucking maintenance. And so they were just like, oh, sorry.
What about a road train? Trucks. Keep Australia moving.
Yeah.
How much did it cost? Because train travel is not cheap. What did it cost you return?
It cost me 150 return. It cost my friend 100 return because he got it earlier.
That's pretty good.
But it was good. There was a guy that noticed me on the train.
And he went,
that's him! He looked like Seth Rogen, and he it was fucking, it was great. We had a good chat.
And he went, ah!
Yeah.
Did he give you grief about the mermaid video?
No.
Oh, okay.
He said, that's really rude because women die. Do you know women die here? How can you make that when women are dying?
What's the weirdest place you've been recognized?
The toilet.
Well, the toilet's not weird. That would happen all the time. Everyone gets
They're like, hey. And I look down, there's a face in the bowl going, are you from Cracker Milk?
Oh, my God.
I recognize that cock. You're from Cracker Milk.
What's the weirdest place you've been recognized? Or the strangest?
She doesn't get recognized.
Never. I never get recognized.
She got recognized at work, actually.
I don't know. I'm not sure if I did or didn't, or if they would, like, you know, I was just,
so you just
had a massive wedge.
Psycho.
I don't know. People tend to, like, I don't know if they're looking at me funny because of something I'm doing, like yelling at my child in public, or like
that lady at the cafe. By the way, I'm not a
troll
fan.
Doll.
She's like all friendly with us now. Like she thinks that she's all friendly with me and Chris. The older lady that served us at the cafe.
Oh, yeah.
Not a fan.
Why is that?
Because she was
nice?
Fucking rude to me
she
and Tamara.
She was really rude really one rude. Day. Really,
oh, really?
Rude.
And, if, and we're petty people.
Don't set me off, Connor.
Just Leo, so
don't,
Leo
you can't,
debate.
You can't bring
podcast.
This up without
fans,
a little bit of anger.
Podcast
through.
Fans, just so you know, me and Tamara, we're in a group called the
Tamara
petty,
and I.
We're in a...
I'm angry at myself.
And let me tell
I'm
you,
angry at
let
myself.
Me tell you, that's a perfect segue, because Tamara and I are in a group I'm naming Petty People. Because we are petty people.
No,
now,
can we call
petty
the petty something cute like petty princesses?
Right, and as you can
is
see, the
fucking
petty
I've got it. I've got it. The petty pea pod.
No, no.
The petty pea pod.
Okay, well,
yeah,
this,
party.
Is, this is the president of the petty people because she's so petty she can't.
You're the
I'm saying
of
petty.
Well, the T and the D are getting very easily mixed up.
Guys, guys, it's going to work.
My face for that.
If you want to bring a petty story to the podcast, you consult the petty.
Oh,
okay. Right.
Now these
Michael
are called.
Jackson?
Now, or? We're the petty people. If you get really petty,
petty
and
people
what they're
segment.
Called are the petty files. All right. So if you have
you
it,
you can't call the petty files.
Do,
exist.
No, we're doing a segment
Richard
called
Petty.
We're doing this the petty files, and it's when you have a petty thing that you want to talk about.
Okay.
Oh, and we can solve your petty quarrels.
Yeah. So any petty, like if you have a pedophile of your own, bring them in. Leave them in the comments. If you want to be a petty person, you can. You just come in and bring your petty
Join
files
us.
In. And
we can make petty merch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we'll call it the petty files because that's the only play on words
right.
we've got.
One for the NASCAR nerds.
I'm still down for some petty peas in a pod. Because it's a podcast. Petty peas
fuck,
in a pod.
Who the fuck is a NASCAR nerd listening to
I'll
this?
I'll start my own.
There might be some.
I'll start my own. Fuck this.
Yeah, can you do me a favor? Stop talking to yourself on a group podcast.
No, I need to.
Yeah,
need
anyway,
to.
So there's a woman at the cafe. She was a bit rude. I asked her the takeaway menu and she went, all of our food's on the takeaway menu, mate. And she did it like that. And in Australia, when you say mate like that, you're actually saying
dickhead.
Dickhead, yeah. Fucking loser. Yeah. And I said nothing. I thought, that was a bit rude. I leave the cafe with Tamara. She goes, that one was a fucking cow. What a fucking bitch.
Oh, no.
What
she
a fucking...
ignited
well,
you, did
it
she?
It was rude. It was rude. Because then the other girl was really sweet. And she was like, oh, actually, yeah. Well, these are our quick options, which is essentially what you're asking for in a takeaway
and
option.
It's not
yes.
day.
In your waitressing days, have you ever been that rude to a customer?
Yep.
I
all the time.
No, I'm only rude to people if they're rude to me first. Because
yeah.
I don't have to stand for that shit. And we were delights when we were asking for the takeaway food.
We, were
we
very
weren't
sweet.
We weren't like, give us your fucking takeaway options. We said, oh, excuse me, sorry, hi.
Wait, no, that's what you sound like though. Most of the time when you're talking, all anyone's hearing is give us your fucking that's how you sound. That's actually something that I've been trying to tell you every podcast. Your voice is so shrill and,
yeah.
and nasally that
I'm surprised you can hear my voice when yours is the one like constantly going.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you can hear your own voice with the fucking size of your mouth because it's so tiny.
Yeah,
I'm
surprised, petite and cute.
I'm surprised
just like
the
whole enchilada here, bitch.
It shouldn't be sounding like this.
Oh, look, we can't all be
and
5'6
most
and just like
fans,
rancid.
Yeah, yeah. And we can't all be 4'3 with flaps that started our belly button. But here we are. Here we are. Two kids.
Sorry.
Two
sorry,
kids.
Sorry.
Each flap as tall as your toddler, and you fucking worked at a cafe on Sunday so you can fucking.
Yeah, if only I got paid here, hey.
Yeah, if only you did. Maybe if you spoke more and you had a deeper voice. Everyone else in the room's getting paid really well, incredibly well.
Yeah.
What salary
are
you on?
Female?
Salary.
Shut up.
And notice salary. How I'm the only woman in the room, too. Oh, so what you're saying is it's a gendered issue.
Yes.
Gender pay gap. The
yes.
gender pay gap.
The gender pay gap exists. Do you know why the gender
I'm
pay gap
free.
Exists? So boys can ride their BMXs
mm-hmm.
off the taller bit down to the lower bit where the women are.
Wow.
So we can ride our BMXs over the pay gap.
Get a sick jump.
If the pay gap wasn't there, how could we ride our BMX bikes and do sick jumps?
77%.
And it's only like a 30% gap, so it's just like a little bunny hop over.
23% gap.
Is it 23%?
I would be prepared for women to get paid the same as us.
I don't know.
If you don't
they
know.
Had to tee off from
you
the same fucking place
this.
We tee off on a golf course.
You can get paid the same as us if that if the week you have your periods,
or,
you weren't so angry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, you're still talking.
You're doing half the
That's
work.
Right.
No wonder you're getting
tennis?
Paid less.
Play
you have
five
periods.
Sets, not three. Five, not three.
Is yeah. anyone encouraging this guy or is he just going? Like, who wound him up
I
before he got
CEO
on the couch?
Owner and
actually, you did because we started talking about media ownership issues
yeah.
and away he went. I knew we were in trouble.
And
you
reminded
me
you're a woman and like fucking like I'm,
I know.
Look at him. He's containing his rage. That's why he's saying nothing.
He's just scared for his life
actually,
next to you.
Actually,
they
just
want
to talk about his train story.
Never trust a boom boom.
What?
What?
Sorry.
Did you do a boom boom on the train?
Did you boom boom on the
no,
train?
No, I didn't.
He came themed.
You went 13 hours on a train without a boom boom.
Well, he had a vacuum, so he stuck his ass out the window
but
like he does here.
Dude, trying to, like, I had to hold in so much gas. And it just like, because I needed to fart. So I like go and fart. But then like sometimes when I would go.
Go and fart?
Yeah, because I didn't want to fart where in the cabin.
You didn't want to fart in the cabin? Fuck me, you fart in here all the time.
There's like a middle part and like I need to go piss.
So you give a fuck about randos on the train, but you don't give a shit about us in a fucking enclosed room with you.
Yeah, I don't know them.
Elias.
But also they're trapped with me for 13 hours in a thing, so...
Every Monday, man, bitch.
If only the Nazis thought like you.
Do you guys think, leave it in the comments, do you guys hate it when we laugh on the podcast? Because Emily says when she listens to podcasts, she doesn't like it when people find themselves funny. But if I didn't find myself funny, I would have committed suicide because that's all I got.
Laugh at yourself, man. That's
yeah.
I laugh at you, dude. Normally I laugh at you and then Goob will say like one of the most heinous dark jokes I've ever heard and that'll get me going.
Inappropriate humor. Goob is all about inappropriate humor.
So quick.
He does.
And you are all about literally sending snuff films to me of
snuff films?
Disabled
snuff
people.
Film. That's not true.
Tamara, do you want to, can I give you my phone? Okay.
No.
And okay.
I would have thought I'd given you a break over the last 2 weeks being away. I haven't
You know what's hilarious is that I messaged you and I was like, are you back in Brisbane? He goes, yep. And then 5 seconds later, I open my phone, person with Down syndrome on my feed. Oh, Goob showing Tamara some examples.
You can just keep scrolling.
Just scroll.
Wait, this is all one-sided.
Yeah, it's just Chris sending endless amount. Look at the amount he sends. Isn't it impressive?
Chris.
Isn't that impressive, the amount he sends? How does a man find so much horrible
Chris!
Shit? What'd you get up for on the weekend, bud?
Oral.
I went down to New South Wales on the train. played with my miniatures down there at a tournament for Metal Earth Strategy Battle Game. And,
He didn't have his morning crayon, so he was tired.
Yeah, no, it was good fun.
Yeah, what did you get up to?
I played Middle Earth Strategy Battle Game.
Yeah, like how was it? What happened? Any fun stories?
I did like a Corsairs of Umbar and like the Morialis, but I brought in the Kraken, so I was like Pirates and the Kraken.
Yeah, and you won?
Yeah, I killed a lot of things.
Did you say
I won? I won Best Display Board, which is very funny.
How many teams were there?
You won Best Display Board?
Yeah.
It was well. It's actually really cool. I saw it.
Yeah.
It's actually really cool.
It's a big pirate ship with like water and stuff.
If
I
never wanted to have sex again, I like would make something like
that.
Yeah,
I wrote that off a while ago.
Tell me, the room where you guys played this.
Yeah.
Did it smell?
No, it was we were at a pub. It was like a function room at a pub.
So it was sticky.
I think Lord of the Rings nerds are like kind of like different sort of nerds. Like
you're not getting that geek stink.
No, they like gaslight women and like try and like gaslight women and act like they can fight in wars and stuff and have long hair. Like basically, Lord of the Rings fans all look like Aragorn. They all try the Aragorn look. You know when you see the ratty, skinny dudes with the and they have a ponytail and the shit beard. And it's just
like the comic book guy.
It's just trying to look like Aragorn, but none of them do it because they're not Viggo Mortensen in their 50s, like shredded, doing fighting training. You don't look like the King of Gondor. You look like
Strider.
I think you're mixing other people with that.
Nah, like, bud, I'm not.
You haven't been to one of these tournaments, man.
Haven't I?
No.
I have.
I'm pretty sure I've been to a tournament like that.
No.
Yeah.
No. Yeah. The Warhammer ones I've been to.
Oh, they stink.
They stink. They fucking stink.
The Nurgle. The Nurgle.
Is that what it's called?
Well, you know what? Next one I'll go. I'll be the judge of this stink.
I love...
No, don't you walk into
I'll be the judge
no,
of this.
You walked
into one of those tournaments. Oh, my God.
It's thick air. It's thick BOA.
I'll go incognito.
You'd have so
What'd
many...
you say? Little beard? Little hair?
They'll
yeah, you're fine.
They'll
you
still
just
blow.
Go in now.
Yeah, go as Trey, dude.
I'll go as Trey. Yeah. I'm not Trey. Who's Trey?
Isn't Trey your character?
Fuck you.
So what did you get up to?
So I played a tournament.
So it was a 12-hour train.
10-hour train, 3-hour bus.
Yeah, you're quite upset last week about the bus.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because like the train goes like that 3 hours from Brisbane to Casino is one of the best parts of that ride.
Mm. I really
and
like
so
that drive.
So having to... Oh, on the train, it like goes through. I'm pretty sure it goes like down kind of towards Girraween area, like through the mountains and stuff down
there. That's
pretty. Which would have been really cool. But instead, we took a bus
and went through the Pacific Motorway or whatever.
But I like that drive. Like, because, like, yeah, I like when nice you finally cross the border and you have that big mountain you sort of go through. It's and then it's like it everything's green. Past and
you
gorgeous.
Used to go over the mountain.
Just past
great.
Tweed, right? Yeah. Just like through Tweed.
Yeah, yeah, just yeah. over the border.
Then. Beautiful.
Yeah, that's cool. But it could have been better.
So you're like, I do that all the time. Though. Yeah. I just want something.
Beach south of Ballina.
Did you say on the way there, oh, you need to shut up about south of Ballina, but you fucking does one film next to the ocean. He's like, I might move here.
No, I fucking will move
here. Have you heard of Ballina?
Northern Rivers.
Have you heard of Ballina? It's absolutely beautiful. Not Ballina. There's a beach
south
here.
Of Ballina.
Lennox.
No, no, south of Ballina.
Lennox.
No. North of Evans Head. Lennox is above there. So.
I love Lennox. Evans Head.
Mm. Evans Head.
Evans
That's
Head is there.
That's where I would
Ballina
love to be.
There. And
I would
the
love it.
Area in
That's
the middle
where your in-laws are, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah.
Never heard of it. Don't display it.
I
no,
love
no
Evans
It's a
Head.
Hidden fucking paradise.
What was that?
And I will retire there.
What are you doing? Are you farting? What are you doing? So you had some bogans on the...
Oh, yeah, it was pretty...
On wrong. The train?
This is the stuff people want to hear about, bro.
Yeah.
So these are the people that aren't allowed to fly Jetstar.
Hang on, you dressed up as a poo. You've had a crazy weekend. You're so quiet on this podcast, mate. Where's all the silliness?
Say why, Elias. Say why you're being quiet.
I know why. He's got the shits. He's got the shits. Because let's talk about it. So you went all the way down there to do a tournament.
Wait, yeah. wait, why?
Where
wait,
you were
the
representing your state.
Yeah, Queensland.
Or your shire. I don't know. Anyway, but you, there were three of you in the team. How many games did you play in the tournament?
Five.
How many
five,
teams
and
were
you
there?
Won how many?
One.
Three of those five.
You won three of the five, and yet your team came ninth out of 10.
Yeah.
So the other two.
Because it's like, because it's like every round.
It's like a debate.
Every three members of the team plays.
Yeah.
And then you have to get at least two wins in that round on your team to count as a win.
So what you're saying is you pulled
like
your
soccer.
Weight. The other two guys fucked up.
No, but there was
do
also,
guys,
but there
guys,
was, like the ones that I lost, like it kind of went both ways. We all
what
kind
you guys,
of fucked up.
What do you guys call?
We won the not great rounds.
What do you guys, don't you hate it when people call
but it's really
call it's soccer losing. Football? Just call it FIFA like it's meant to be called. Imagine everyone playing soccer calling it FIFA.
Check a ball.
Sorry about that. Cut that one. Cut that one too.
But yeah, no, the train ride there was better than the train ride back. But the train ride there, about half of the train for about 4 hours, there were these two bogans that were just like swearing their tits off. Going on a really bogan train with like loud music playing.
Last Train
for,
to
like,
Frio. Good movie. But yeah, okay, that's a very fucking scary film. I've been stuck in a train with some fucking bogans. Last Train to Frio.
Don't point at me. Don't point like that's a thing we know about or something we're going to do.
I don't
no one's going to watch it. That's you all the time.
And then on the way back, there was a bogan family that wouldn't shut up. They're having arguments the whole time. And I was trying. This one was overnight time. And it was fucking hard to.
It was Elias just, with his mum,
really?
Because he kept shitting his nappy every time she'd change it. And she said, I'm only going to change your nappy if you stay in it for long. And you went, yep, and you boom in it straight away, didn't you?
Yeah, it was white. I'm still wearing those clothes.
What was the seating? What was the seating like? Just like TransLink seating?
No, it's like it's New South Wales TransLink. But the seats were pretty decent size, and you've got heaps of room and everything, and you can.
But
like
$75 one way or whatever.
Yeah.
That's pretty.
Yeah, but you can get that on a plane now if you book
it.
Yeah,
but in advance,
it was like about
if you can plan your life and pray to God it doesn't get cancelled.
Like it's done in an hour rather than 13 hours. With fucking,
that was, I would never catch
but
it.
But if it was $100, it's like a third of the price, I guess.
Yeah, and I always catch a plane.
Budget.
I would catch a plane.
I'm transphobic.
But I mean, I also... That was pretty good.
That was really good.
He doesn't like trains.
Did you plot that whole thing from the get-go?
There was an article in the paper this morning about a girl who went away camping with her girlfriends. And she's now pregnant, but her husband is unable to have children.
How so?
So she has that
he's
a Ken
doll.
That's right. He's infertile, and she has said, and he believes her that she was fucked by Bigfoot while she was camping. That Bigfoot fucked her.
I'm sorry. Wait, circle back. This isn't in America.
I mean,
yeah, of course. Okay.
Well, then, yeah, I'd believe it.
I believe
you know
it.
What they say
That's
about
Bigfoot is.
You know what they say
because here we have yowies.
Yeah, exactly.
And you know what they say about big feet? Blurry footage.
Oh, my God.
Japanese blurry footage.
What?
I just noticed a lot of the porn in
like
Japan
the pixelated
was pixelated.
Yeah. I bought a dirty mag at a Japanese, like, 7-Eleven.
Mm-hmm.
because
they're on every corner.
They are, and when in Japan,
ABC, is that what they're called? No,
Family Mart.
Family Mart.
And I went in and got one, and like all the dirty mags have tape over them, so you
like Dolly Doctor.
You can't open them. And I was like, oh, I thought a dirty mag would be like kind of normal comparative to the videos, because like it's a magazine, and in all the mags they're all censored, so they have like full on nude shots, but all the bits are like whited out. I'm like, oh, okay, that's fine. And it came with a DVD, and I was like, oh, that's interesting. The DVD was the video, all the videos. So the mag was like an ad for the videos, and I put it in, and they're the same. It's almost like they screen grabbed it. I swear to God, they exist with blurry genitals.
Yeah, well, no, it's just, it's not actually blurred in the magazine. It's a scratch and sniff.
In the magazine, it was like a white, it was like a white little mark.
Has that been done? Because I'm going to take the shotgun.
It's literally, sometimes there'll be like a girl giving head, a photo of it, and they've blurred it, but they haven't blurred the girl giving head. They've just made the dick look like a ghost cock, like she's giving head to like a white, it's really weird. Like,
wasn't there a thing in Japanese they couldn't show pubic hair?
Yeah, you're not allowed to.
So you could, like if that was shaved and that was, but yeah, which...
No, but you're allowed to show an octopus tentacle inserting itself within a pixelated crevice.
I'm pretty sure what you bought was a paint-by-number adult version book.
But the only thing I'm painting by numbers are the genitals.
Yeah.
Why did you buy it?
Adult version.
When in Japan.
Okay. In Japan. Maybe that's why everything else is so fucked up.
The red light district in Japan is as big as Brisbane City, and I think that's insane.
In Tokyo? Mm. Is there a red light district in Tokyo?
It is fucking enormous. Like you just, you're like walking and you're in the red light and you won't leave it.
Surely it's a massive tourist trap though. They'd be paying like...
I think...
there's so many tourist traps in Tokyo.
There is a lot of places in there, and the one that blew my mind was the blowjob bar, and women were included, and women cost 10 yen more.
What do you mean? So you choose to be the blower or the blowee?
No, so you go in and it's a bar.
A glory hole.
And you pay, and they have people that'll come and suck you off under the table where you sit with your mates.
Really?
Yeah. How much? And you walk past, so it's 50 for a guy.
No.
And 60 for a girl.
What?
Yeah.
To blow you.
Yeah. So you just pay. Yeah, like, I get
that's
a drink.
Like $1.20.
I'll go drink, get some head. And they're like, sweet, no worries. You want teeth or no teeth? And then you make your extras, and then you go sit down and they...
This was in Tokyo.
Yeah.
I didn't go.
I had a partner at the time, but... And also, I would never do that.
And you were going to say, did a Valentine's. That's what stopped you.
But yeah, it was. There's a lot of porn.
Wait, but would I be able to go...
And get head, yes.
I do
and
know
And it's
someone.
Cheaper for me.
No, it's more expensive.
No, you said men. As a straight woman, I could pick a man for less
than a woman. No, it's $10 for you. $10 more for you than it would be for me. Yeah. So it's 60
because
for you. Because you're a girl and pussies are gross and dicks are simple. Mm. I see one time this old lady came up to us, this tiny little like 80-year-old woman. She goes, and I was like, oh, you okay? And she like needs help and we just get her off the road. She goes, stay here, and pulls out a flip phone in 2018 and just starts calling up some girls for us and telling us she's going to get us girls. It was a pimp. That old lady was a pimp. She was baiting us in to try and get us prostitutes. And we went, no, and walked off.
Wait,
was scary.
That's their front of house?
Yeah. She's like, she's just on the street, like trying to go up to tourists and like asks for help and then goes, oh, thank you, I'll help you, and then tries to get you girls.
That's like using like a gross old carrot to sell a carrot cake.
How gross is the carrot?
Speaking of cake.
Oh, we've got cake.
Yeah. Are we allowed to do it?
Yeah, do it now.
You didn't seem keen on the sharing and the caring of the birthday cake.
No, I want to share and care. I wanted like more people here. So
do you want to go get the cake?
Oh, that's cute.
Do you want to go get some slice of cake?
That's a delightful thing to do.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Yeah,
thanks.
Okay.
Producer.
Have some. Oh, he's just given up.
No, I'm going to show you.
Chris is on his phone.
Japanese. Have I shown this? Detective Butthead. Detective Butt.
No, he's just watching videos
this is
on a
butt
podcast.
Detective. This is a Japanese.
They can't see that.
They can't see that?
No.
Well, I do.
Discuss it. Don't show it.
So how are you defeating? See, he farts on them.
Oh.
It's good.
You know,
it's
in
Japanese
real life now,
cartoons.
Chris is so addicted to his phone when he reads books, he pinches at the screen to try and enlarge the words in the book. Sometimes when
fair,
he's looking
I've
at his wife naked, he goes up to her breasts and he tries to pinch at them and to enlarge them. I know it's disgusting. Like, you're really disgusting. You can't just stretch to
what
zoom,
are you
dude.
Say about that?
Look, some things I choose to ignore because to feed it just allows it to continue.
Like hair growth, you ignore that for a while, didn't you?
Hair growth.
Yeah, you chose to ignore growing hair.
He is so angsty today.
He is. Yeah.
Am I? What happened?
Angsty. Am I too angsty for you guys?
Very angsty. No, not too much.
My energy's up. I'm just trying to make jokes, keep the audience engaged, make fresh ones. Next to a guy dressed as a poo, so.
It's pretty fun.
Trying to figure
it out. You should try it out.
No, I never will. Really? I never will try this out. I'll never dress like that.
Why?
Because.
Never. I don't, say never.
It's the confidence you have stresses me out.
Why?
Okay, it's kind of hot.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, let's just put this picky on your Hinge and let it pop off.
How's Hinge going? You trying to chickies? No?
I'm busy.
Busy?
What?
Yeah, being in New South Wales.
He has been very busy.
New South Wales.
So you had 13 hours there on Hinge to just swipe away.
I don't have any reception on the train.
When did you go?
Like, I don't, what? I can't, like.
They have a Wi-Fi, surely.
When did you go? Where did you catch a train?
Actually, it was.
On Friday.
Oh, where'd you go?
New South Wales.
Oh, cool. That's pretty cool.
How long was the journey?
26 hours all up, there and back.
So, you're not chatting any chicks?
Kind of, but I'm like, I'm not putting a lot of effort into it. But
like,
just
he says, hey, sorry,
like,
can I please get a coffee?
Kind of, he calls them up.
Hey,
go,
can you pay?
They go, hello, and he goes.
Yeah, I can't.
Show me.
Did you see that?
Show me.
I heard, but then I'll just say.
Why are you looking at a photo of Nigel Thornberry's wife?
I want you to wear the bandana.
Why are you looking at that?
I've been out of the country.
No, why are you specifically looking at that?
That he used to wear, but he stopped. I don't know why.
Because you two bullied me. Stop wearing my fucking glasses for sight. Because you two made fun of me too much. You just called me Jeffrey Dahmer, which I wasn't that affected by. You offering to take me to a glasses shop because you hated them so much you want a new frame. Fucked me up, bro. That's fucked up. I'll do you a favor. I'll stop you from being ugly. Like, that's fucked.
No, I didn't say you were ugly.
We should get to wear the glasses again and then get that red scarf. Yeah.
Oh my God. Yeah. Could we do
that? Why? You weren't here when this happened. Why are you looking at Nigel Thornberry's wife? Who led you on to this?
The news hath travelled, sir.
Yeah, how did
the news hath travelled.
Via trade. It's him on a train.
I'm coming!
He sends a raven out to tell Chris that I look like Nigel Thornberry's wife.
So good, though. Don't you reckon?
Yeah.
Did you see? Roll the clip. Did you see the video of him dancing?
Do you reckon she gives Blumpkins?
No, I haven't seen that. Oh, okay.
Sorry, I've got a
little treat to come. Do you reckon Nigel Thornberry's wife was given Nigel Blumpkins?
Wait, what's a Blumpkin again?
When you're pooing and you get head.
Is that an actual thing?
Really?
I don't know. I'm sure people poo and get head.
What do you mean?
If you want to name
that. It feels very messy.
Is that true?
There's nothing on the plates. They're empty.
Boom, 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 boom.
Yeah.
Boom, 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 boom.
Usher.
I did. Boom, boom.
Yeah.
In boom, boom room.
So the boom, boom room used to be, like, boom, boom was fucking in my day. And the boom, boom room was the bedroom,
so,
right?
Dude, it's still the same.
No, it's the same boys.
It's the same now.
No. That doesn't work because Vanga Boys said,
boom, boom's used for fucking.
Boom, 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 boom. I want you in my room.
Mm. And
boom,
what is a room?
Boom, boom, let's go back to my room so we can
what is
do
a room?
It all night.
It's a place where you go,
no,
boom,
I think
boom.
They're just making a sick beat.
No, there was a song called boom, boom, boom. Let's go back to my room so we can do it all
literally.
Am I killing you not?
No, Vanga Boys. Boom, 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 boom. I want you in my room.
No, no, no. Long before that.
I fucked that boom boom in my own room.
Audience, how are you liking the Crack and Bull podcast? Are you enjoying the silliness?
Ooh,
or
rough.
Are we not doing enough? Do we need more discussion? Because we've just been going and doing silly ones. I've got a few plans. I want us to have a spa day where we have bathrobes on, all sorts of stuff. But leave your suggestions in the comments. Be sure to talk to us because I read all the comments and they're very important, particularly on the stuff like this where there's only like 1,000 of you watching right now. So it's more sincere. I will take in the advice.
You okay though? You're like sitting hiccups. Like you're kind of dying for like
you know when
oxygen.
You get the hiccups when you're drunk and they just don't fuck off?
Yeah.
I hate that when you're walking around like this.
Oh, when you're drunk.
Yick.
Yeah.
And they feel
I
like
hate
they're...
when you feel great. You're on top of the world. You're like, I'm in my buzz zone. And then you lay down and it spins.
Oh, yeah.
You're doing these ones.
And then, but once it starts the spin,
it doesn't
you
stop.
Can't get off the
no,
ride.
You're gonna throw up.
You got to get it out.
Which reminds me of someone. Did you guys know that when
Please
we shot?
Please don't.
Why?
No.
You don't
no.
want
Can
people
I play
to
a song
know that you're going to drunk.
Can I play a song for you?
Why?
Is that going to be okay?
Will it get copyrighted?
Probably.
Mums can drink.
That's the thing.
Really
Tamara drank and then the kids.
Happy birthday to you.
You're 3 years old.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday. Cake looks like a poo.
It does look like a big poo.
That is the ugliest cake I've ever seen.
No, shut up. It's beautiful.
It's a beautiful cake.
It's homemade.
This looks like if you said shit a brick, that's what that shit would look like.
It looks like it literally.
Is that
too much smoke?
It's fine.
Nah, it's fine.
Dude, just blow the candles out. It's stressing me out. You guys are telling me that doesn't look like a dog poo.
No, it looks exactly
like it looks like crusty white dog shit, and I think that's fine. Like,
does it? Poo comes out square.
Okay, how are you going to do that?
Huh?
Poos don't come out square.
You're telling me that to you, you can look at that.
Do you know what I think it looks like?
It looks so good inside.
It does look amazing.
Do you know those bars that you get? Those Golden Gay Time.
Golden Gay Time.
Is that what they're called?
Golden
the
Gay
Time. The birthday boy's saying the N-word. No, you got to bleep that.
And it's coconut around the outside, and it.
Summer roll.
Summer
roll. Tamara.
Why?
Do you know what summer rolls look like? Crusty white dog
shit.
That's
true.
Like it looks like.
That's true.
It's. I
gotta get the bottom.
Now Elias's mum listens to these, and just so you know, it looks delicious. Oh, like okay. Genuinely, I'm gonna say, looks great.
I can't wait.
Can't wait to eat this, but it looks like a big.
She
dog
would be
poop.
Rolling, it like just amazing. Like I don't want Connor to eat my son's birthday cake.
Yeah, I don't think
cake.
She probably wants me to eat me.
That's not how you eat cake, by the way.
Stop it. That's what it's tomorrow.
I don't want that.
He did his own.
I got no room to
You cut your own, dude.
Someone clearly did.
Stop cutting it. Put the knife down, bro. We'll deal with it.
Everyone DIY.
Fucking hell.
Dude, it's not soup. Don't slurp it up.
Tamara, can you please take that knife away from him before he hurts?
He'll be right.
Yeah, no, I got no room to put shit.
Please, Elias, my ass.
Did you have a moment on the train where you thought, I'm an adult now? I'm 30 years old.
I did actually.
I'm sitting on a fucking train.
Yeah.
With some
toddlers running around until 9 o'clock at night.
That could have been you. You could have been a papa. Jesus fucking Christ, dude.
Yeah.
Have half the amount. You don't have to. If your face is tensing when you have to take a bite, that's too big.
Is it?
Goob, he just went like this. He put food and he went. His face was straining from the sheer size of the bite. No, dude, relax. It's okay. There's no. I'm 30 now. I've got to eat quick.
Nice.
It is really nice. And thank you to Elias's mum. You're a lovely woman.
Mm.
And you've raised a very beautiful 30-year-old boy.
It's in your beard.
Perfect.
And I'm sorry. I'm sorry, genuinely, that I made fun of your cake for looking like poo when it tastes delicious. But maybe lay off the stuff on the side that makes it white. If you look at it on the side, it looks like crusty white dog poo.
It does look like crusty white dog poo.
Thank you, thank you. Can you keep that bit in where Eli said it looks like dog poo so I don't get in trouble with his mum? I'm scared of your mum.
It looks great.
I'm scared of your mum, dude.
I did not recognise you in that. Like, I still don't feel like that is you.
The photo that shaped it up.
It's not me.
It's
not me.
Thank you.
That's not me.
Is that not
this? Well, this was a fucking meme.
Okay,
from,
good.
Like, 2011.
Okay, thank God, because I was like, I don't see it. I don't know.
Something has happened. It's at some German nightclub, underage nightclub. My friend Joel at the time found that photo and just kept posting it saying it was me, and then it just spread, and then everyone started using it as, they're like, cool. Yeah, this is you. But it's like some underage German nightclub.
Because I was like, something happened. Like, this has been, like, someone cloned Elias along the way, and like...
You should put this when someone memeing you, saying you're a person at an underage nightclub, in the petty files. You should talk about how you weren't at the underage nightclub during the petty files segment.
Oh, I'm so excited for the petty files segment.
Does anyone have any petty files we want to throw in before we leave?
Goob, what's your petty gripes?
Petty files.
Goob does have...
Oh, he'd have heaps.
Goob has a bunch, but they're the opposite of mine. He has his own petty files that are different.
Mm.
What's your favourite petty file?
Michael Jackson.
Do you know what gets me? When you're going down an escalator and the people have the whole fucking journey to decide where they want to go, but they don't, and they wait till they're at the bottom of the escalator and they stall and they're like,
Because it's very much a Queensland thing to fucking stand on escalators.
Yeah, it drives
my
fucking,
God.
You know, I don't mind.
If you're going to stand, shove over to the left.
Yeah, correct. I don't mind until
get
there's,
out of the
until
whole
there's
area.
A bunch of on an escalator, staring like, and there's a family of them on four steps, and I'm just trying to get down to my appointment.
Oh, to
and
the I left, can't get bitch, to, my to the left.
I can't get to my appointment on time because people don't keep to the fucking left.
Oh.
Then you go to Japan, everyone's to the left.
Everyone knows
what up. And
Hiroshima
has just been ignited by an atom bomb never seen before by humanity, but at least everyone's keeping single file.
I don't know.
I'm keen to see. $50 blow I'm job. Honestly keen to see the Eve bomb.
Thanks for listening to another episode of the Crack and Milk podcast. If you want the full uncut, uncensored version of the podcast, you can
get it. Better be fucking censored.
No one wants this shit.
Not on Patreon. You've got to cut out all this stuff, though.
I feel like we've only got like 30 minutes of a podcast.
No, bro. We don't.
Let's circle back in. Let's pick a topic. Any topic.
Pedophiles. Not like pedophiles.
Petty files. Yeah, the petty files. We don't talk about pedophilia.
Okay, so what's another petty-ish?
You're the president.
Okay, well, hear ye. Huh. Escalator. Continue on. Next one.
You had a bitch about waitresses.
Elevator. People being...
about kids and people that don't control their kids on trains?
Do you know what I hate about an elevator? Do you know what I hate about an elevator?
Why do you have things that you hate for everything?
People who get in the elevator and then they stand at the door of the elevator and then when you get in on the next floor... You have to like push past them awkwardly because they're just so desperate to be at the fucking front. You're the first one on to go to the back.
Actually, one a petty file that I would like to bring up. when you're catching transport, when you're on the transport and you're trying to get off, like you're at your stop and people don't let you get off before they get on. And so they're like trying to, they just push past.
I remember
trains, buses.
I remember a woman's face because I remember getting off at Fortitude Valley Station and the doors open and I go to leave and she is trying to storm her way in. And I'm like, I just go to leave and she goes, oh, excuse me, as she's trying to storm in. And I remember being like, fuck you, and walking off. And I remember her because I was like, that's the rudest shit I've ever, like,
always off.
How would you fit in?
It's illogical. It's illogical. It's always off.
Do you know what also gets me?
Put that in the files.
You know when you put it in a file.
That's in the petty files.
You know when you have, like, you go to someone's like powder room toilet sort of thing, and they have those tiny little fucking sinks, and for some reason they have the highest water pressure in those taps than they have in the whole house.
That's just a lack
of common
sense.
And you turn it off, and it splashes up in your shit.
That's actually,
and then you look like you pissed yourself.
Well, you don't find love
because of the tiny sink.
If you live in a house with that sink and you're okay with it, you're not going to find love.
No.
Okay, petty thing I don't like.
There's nothing.
Is when you're driving and you're at a four-way intersection and people are telling you to get go, like letting you go, but it's their right of way. Like, you know what actually speeds up the process?
Just
not you looking at me like I'm an idiot for not taking your favor of letting me go. Just you fucking going when you're meant, like, you're not doing me a favor because you're stupid. And they do this, they go,
But let me just say, though, you live, so where these guys live here is... There is a fucking heap of intersections.
The old.
So
they've all got
bad.
Four-way intersections, and every fucking one has got a pedestrian crossing.
It's fucked.
So you've got to fucking look out 85 different fucking ways,
it's
and
so
everything
stupid.
Comes to a grinding halt. It is so fucking stupid.
I want to know who the town
planner
was.
Nowhere else in the fucking world has this fucking thing that you guys have got here.
Give me the town planner's name.
What about intersection town?
But they don't have fucking...
They do. Four-way intersection town has intersections, like, everywhere, dude.
Four-way intersection town is a gay bar.
That's great.
That's a good petty.
It drives me up the bloody wall, I tell you what.
I
don't have a car that is meant to be able to go up walls yet. I don't have a designer,
petty
but mine
files.
Can.
Petty file out.
Petty
file.
You know, I feel like Connor has a petty file, Tamara has a petty file, but I think Elias, you have some pretty big petty files.
Do I?
Yeah, under the hood.
Do I?
Yeah.
Like what?
I don't know. There's a lot works you up. There's a lot that gets you upset.
I don't think there is.
I think there is. You genuinely came into work in a
Bogan's
bad
on
mood.
Trains.
You came into work in a bad mood this morning. You know why?
You were
because
like
he spray
a
painted his models too much, and they were too gunky.
Yeah.
And he was genuinely. He didn't come to the gym. He's like, I'm not coming in. I've got to do this morning. And he spray painted his models too much. And
that's
he came
not
in,
petty though. I understand that.
No, it was the spray paint was like it.
See? And that is not a petty file.
Oh, wait, hold up.
When it goes on all chalky and stuff and it ruins your fucking miniature.
So it's the paint is shit. Is
no,
the issue?
Paint the paint's good, but sometimes you get fucked in
what
like
color
clogs
was the paint?
And stuff. It's like a grey kind of
like
so how do you fix
primer?
That? Do you have to get a little sandpaper?
I have to get rid of all the paint. I have to strip it of paint.
How?
I have to put in isopropyl
don't,
alcohol.
This is what... don't start
and
because you
get a toothbrush and fucking rub it on it and stuff.
This is how he came into work. Hey, man, how you doing? Fine. Fucking annoyed.
Mm.
What do you mean? Why are you annoyed? Because my fucking models are all chalky. Anyway, very funny morning.
Miniatures.
No, so it's I've lost so much detail.
You know how hard it
can
is?
Can they just not I mean, be a little
obviously
bit
obviously very
thick,
hard to paint miniatures because you got to get shit. The detail.
Yeah.
Why don't you just paint fucking normal size shit?
Thanks for listening to another episode of the Crackable Podcast. If you want to follow the full thing, it's on Patreon. It's uncut, uncensored. We are trying very hard to make our Patreon a very fun place for all of our fans. And if you want to follow Tamara, go to Instagram. She posts absolutely nothing. And if you want to follow Chris,
no,
go for it. He
I
posts
will.
Nothing.
I'm about to launch.
Yeah.
And if you want to come to my Instagram and follow me, I also post nothing. Last thing I think I posted was 4 years ago.
Yeah.
But I'm still on there to look at stuff, but I just don't post anything.
Yeah.
I should post stuff.
Yeah, start posting some of your petty files.
Okay.
I really want to do a video where you're in giving birth and we find out there's like a suddenly like a 70% chance the baby's not going to make it, and I go oh, and I turn the corner and I start jerking off and everyone stops and goes what the fuck are you doing, and I go good things come to those who wank, and that's the video.
I got a pee-pee out of my stiffy.
You have a stiffy?
But like have you heard about like the German Nancys?
Yeah, I have heard about that one.
Don't hold your cock. It's my stiffy.
All right,
can we cut?
Yeah.
Okay.
God, this cake looks like shit!